Hey guys, I'm here chilling out at the dance studio, doing what I love to do, dance. But what makes it extra special today is I'm chilling with my girl Simone Simmons. She's a dope dancer and an even better choreographer. She always brings the sexiness, the spiciness, and the boldness. And those are the same flavors I want to translate into a dish today. I want to do something that's sexy, spicy, and as hot as she is.
I like a good pointed toe. Don't give me dead feet. Dead feet are ugly. This is a dead foot. It needs to be like
I'm a hip-hop
this
dancer.
Or like this.
I'm a hip-hop dancer.
So
I ain't getting all that technique.
No. Hip-hop dancers know something
technique.
Is going on with their feet. It doesn't look like this. That's ugly as hell.
I got you.
Put me out. Come and put me out. I'm burning up. Come, put me out. Come and put me out. There you go.
Okay.
Boom, like that. And then you're gonna step down left, step down right, okay? And then you're gonna fan over. Exactly. See, look at you guys. Y'all fast learners. Everybody was in motion. You look like, you look kind of like Destiny's Child.
Yeah, okay. Never.
I'm Beyonce. Wait a minute. Did you not see the hair?
I'm
Wait.
Saying.
That's, no. That's
you're
Michelle.
Oh, shoot.
Today's dish is inspired by Simone's sexy, spicy, and bold choreography. And those are some of the same elements and flavors that I want to incorporate into today's dish. Today we're going to be whipping up some sexy Yukon Gold potatoes that are Cajun and accordions. On top of that, we're going to add a nice cabbage that's cooked down in bacon fat and jalapenos. And then with that, we're going to have a nice center cut beefsteak wrapped in bacon. We know everything tastes better than bacon. When dealing with meat, you always dealing with bacon. So we're going to get started on our cabbage. Our nice jalapeno bacon cabbage. I already started slicing up a couple of bacon slices, but I'm gonna slice them even thinner just so that it can really break down that fat and all of those flavors can get absorbed into the jalapeno cabbage. Now the great thing about cooking with bacon is that you don't need to grease your pot. Why? Because bacon fat is fat and it greases the pan for you. So I'm gonna go ahead and just wait for that to get hot. And then I'm gonna throw my bacon in there and you're gonna hear the nice sound that comes out that makes me get really excited. Next, I'm gonna cut my jalapenos. So, you can't have bacon jalapeno cabbage without jalapenos. So these jalapenos are already washed and rinsed off, just like any of the other vegetables I'm gonna use today. And I'm gonna cut off the tops. Hey, look, like little hats. I'm gonna cut off the top, and then I'm gonna slice down the middle. The heat comes from the seeds in the jalapeno, not necessarily the jalapeno itself, but today we want all the spiciness, and I think that's enough heat right there. Looks like our pot is ready, so let's go ahead and throw the bacon in there. Watch this. Oh yeah, you hear a lot. And it starts to get those really good fumes in a second. All right, yo, my mother used to get so upset. Don't be scraping the bottom of my pots. Those cost money. Not no more, Mom. With a spoon. Make sure we get that nice and rendered. While we have that going, I'm gonna go ahead and throw in the jalapenos, which are gonna cook down and create a nice base for the cabbage to lay on. I wish you got to smell this. It smells great. This looks absolutely amazing. I can't wait to try it. Again, just a quick reminder, we have our nice accordion potatoes, and you can see that they actually opened up a bit, so you really get those flavors that are deep inside of each ridge. We have our nice, sexy, spicy jalapeno and bacon cabbage. And then we have the star of our dish, our center cut beef steak medallion wrapped in bacon with those same Cajun flavors on top and on the bottom. Let's dig in.
Oh, I'm so excited, so excited, so excited.
Oh man. Whew. I've been waiting for this entire segment. Now that is how you make steak. Potatoes have that perfect crunch and crisp to them. Let's take a bite of this cabbage. And in this bite, since I know this is filled with jalapenos, I'm gonna actually put some pineapple in this bite. Perfect blend of everything. I'm telling you, that pineapple was a good touch to kind of kick back on some of that spiciness. You get the bacon taste in there, you get the bacon fat, you get all of the nice flavors and juices that marinate into all of these pieces. Guys, this is a winner. I don't care what holiday it is, what event it is, this dish right here is a winner. Thanks for tuning in. I hope to see you all in the next episode of Aint Kitchen.